Hi, my name is Ezekiel. Hope you are doing well today. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to route and print MIDI drums into Multitrack using Addictive Drum in Cakewalk by BANDLAB. I'm going to show you the importance of printing down the MIDI drums into Multitrack. This is going to give me more advantage to manipulate the drums like in real time, like Pro does. I'll be able to mix and treat each kit differently compared to the way everything it is in the Addictive Drum. Though Addictive Drums is one of the great drums which I so much love, and I love it beyond anything because it gives me the chance to route and print every of the kits into Multitrack in my Cakewalk by BANDLAB. Don't be afraid. If you're not using Cakewalk by BANDLAB, maybe your DAW have the capability of routing into MIDI or printing down like I'm going to do here. You can do it. But this is so lovely, and this is an exciting thing which I want to show you today. But before we do that, if you're new to this channel and you're just watching me for the first time, please, I will encourage you to subscribe so you'll be able to know when the new series comes out from me. And I have series of videos on drums, which talks about drum saturation, the effect of saturation on drums, how to create your own drum samples. Check this one. And let's go into that now. I'm going to show you properly how everything works in Cakewalk by BANDLAB. All right, firstly, I'll be routing out each kit into a separate output. I'm not going to use a separate output master because I wouldn't want the process signal to go into my each kit. So I don't want that. I want to be able to manipulate each kit to be able to mix them. So I'm doing that now. Including the flex, because I have a Google overhead room kit. This is exactly what I needed from this kit right now. Okay, now so the next thing for me is to create my multi-track channel and route everything into Addictive Drums. So look at the way I'm gonna do that. Firstly, I'm gonna create my the number of tracks that I need for the drums. So I'm selecting creating folder, I'm creating bars, then everything is good now. Now everything is created. So firstly, I'm gonna label everything as it is in the Addictive Drum box. So firstly, so kick. So everything is created now. So the next thing that remains for me to do is routing, and I'm gonna color and I'm gonna rename the drums folder. Drums, then coloring. I love using blue color. Then I'm going to the output drum bus. Drums, I'm also gonna color it. All right, my Addictive Drum is ready to be tracked now. So now for me, I'm gonna use console view to make it more easier and faster for me to route. Okay, selecting kick. which I use for cowbell, also known as Agogo Flex 2, Flex 3, then my overheads. So the overhead, I'm gonna select stereo for the overheads. So stereo 13, overhead left, overhead right, overhead 13 plus plus 14 S. That means stereo in Cakewalk. So then my room. So I'm gonna select stereo room. Now all of this is set and I'm ready to track my drums like a pro. Okay, going back. So now I'm gonna track. Are you ready to go with me? So let's hear and see how it's gonna sound like. Okay, now that everything is set, let's listen to what we just recorded. I'll solo each kit so we can listen to them. By the way, before we do that, I'll have to mute the MIDI file. That's the kick, right? Snare drum. Pitch it. Okay. Heads. That's what it is. Okay. You can put it together. Not more than this. So my MIDI drum into multi-track, it's ready for mix. So if you really enjoyed this video, please don't hesitate to thumb up for me. So by doing this, you are encouraging me to create more content for people to watch and to learn from. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye for now.